What is going on, guys? Chris here from Adamantum Productions, and I just had one of my favorite photo shoots I've ever had. And that was when I used these smoke grenades. I've seen a lot of smoke grenade photography, and it's always been something I've been so excited about, but I never really had the gear, the patience, and the photographers to do it. So I put on a quick poll on my Instagram asking people if they would, you know, take pictures of me in this situation. Because usually I'm always taking pictures of other people, and I you know, sometimes want pictures of myself. That's completely normal. So I sent it out, but most of the replies were people who wanted the pictures taken of themselves. And that was a little frustrating. So I was like, you know what? Let's go to the most reliable people I know, my family. So I asked my mom and my sister. My mom used to be a photographer, or she is a photographer. She's really good at it. You can see by these pictures, it is crazy. So yeah, I just want to go over some quick tips that I learned from this photo shoot so that your photo shoots are more productive and work out better. Tip number one is know the gear you're using, camera gear obviously, know the autofocus, what best settings to use on your camera, and that just comes from experience. My mom was using, I'm just gonna say the photographer. The photographer was using the Canon EOS R, and we know we trust the autofocus a lot. And it has a pretty good shooting speed. You want a camera that can shoot pretty fast. And I knew the full frame sensor would be able to capture a good wide image. I think we shot most of them around 16 to 35 mil, and they came out amazingly. So I recommend shooting wider with a camera that has good autofocus and pretty fast bursting, because it was pretty much bursted all the way through. Next thing, try to close the aperture as much as you can just to get as much in focus as possible. I was actually shot this thing around about an f4, and the image came out pretty good because I still wanted a little bit of a blurry background, so it was pretty cinematic. So yeah, I think shooting around f4 is recommended. Shutter speed, I brought it up to about 320 to 400, and yeah, I feel like it was fast enough for this smoke. It wasn't gonna have any motion blur, so no problems there. Next thing is to know your grenades. This is the first time I used these grenades. They didn't really produce as much smoke as I thought they would. They still produced a pretty good amount, and I learned that if I just kept it still in the same spot for a while before moving it around, it allowed the smoke to kind of gather up and create a decent cloud. For my next shoot, I'm probably gonna use two at the same time so that I would just get a thicker cloud of smoke. And yeah, it was still worked really well, and I still love the shot. But for next time, I'm probably gonna explode two at the same time so that I have a significant more amount of smoke. Next thing, know your location. We chose this alleyway. I was planning to do it by the Seine in Paris, but then I found this alleyway walking there, and it was great because it was blocked off on both sides so that a lot of wind doesn't mess up the shots, because wind is a huge factor on how good the images will come. If there's a lot of wind, the smoke will just be blown away really quickly. The wind doesn't allow it to grow and create, you know, a lot of puffy, cloudy smoke, which is what you want. And so know your location, know where it's windy. Try to shoot when it's not super windy or in locations that don't have a lot of wind. Next thing, post-processing. In terms of editing the pictures, I recommend using something that really pushes the colors a lot and really shows how vibrant they are, if that's your mood. If you're going for a darker mood, then that's always an option, but this is what I went for. So first what I did was I slapped on my preset, links in the description if you want to use it. And then after I put that preset on, it allows me to isolate any color I want, and I was able to push the colors even more, and it was just beautiful. That's it, guys. Really quick video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Chris here from Adamantum Productions. I'm really starting to enjoy making these videos, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.